Hello and welcome everybody, I'm from Bavarian, and today we're going to jump into Songs of Silence, a game produced here in Bavaria, so they basically have home turf advantage on the channel, and a game that you can play as well. This demo was given to me by the developers so that I can play it, but as this video goes live, so does the demo, so you can check this out for yourself. And I would definitely recommend doing this. This is a game in the spirit of Heroes of Might and Magic. It definitely has some classic 4X stuff in there as well, some auto battling, a lot of stuff going on. You're gonna see this of course throughout the video, and if you check out the demo yourself. Now what I do want to say is that in this game there will be a proper campaign. In the demo itself there is one mission, in the early access version coming out in May there will be four missions, and then in the full game roughly 4 to 5 months afterwards there will be of course the proper eight. See, this one mission is basically what I expected. When I opened this game I said to myself, alright, let's hop into the mission, maybe show that off on video, and then I found out, oh my god, listen, that mission is fun and all, but they have a full-blown skirmish mode in this demo right here. Again, you can check this out yourself as well if you want to see exactly how this game works before deciding on Kickstarter and so on. In this skirmish map mode, obviously there is a ton of stuff that is locked. You can see it right here. All of these fate options are indeed locked except for one, which just reveals the entire map at the start of the game. But you also have a huge map right here where you have a dark and a light side, and you can play with up to 6 players. We're not going to do this. We're just going to run a bit of a basic game right here. And you can already see that we are locked here in as well into just the Thousand Kingdoms, but there are already a ton of heroes running around. And this is the funny thing to me, right? You see all of these heroes, half of them roughly are locked. If I select the High Lord though, the High Lord himself also has variations. And this is basically true for every single hero. So the variations that you will eventually be getting with this game, just because of the heroes being as varied as they are, I think is going to be quite significant. Now, like I said, we are just going to play against one AI. We're just going to do a quick match, explore the mechanics, and then I'll let you go into the demo yourself. Let's take a look and let's just jump in. I really gotta say, by the way, the 2D art and the 3D art in this game are gorgeous. This right here, you can see in the background, is the portal that leads into the underworld or into the dark world, but this is very consistent in this game. The UI, the map, everything is absolutely beautiful, and I gotta say, that is always a really, really good sign. This map is the entire map that we're going to be playing on here today. You can see that there are several markers. We have our own base, we have our own city, and then there are outposts, there are roaming armies, and so on. We're gonna get to that in a second. The big question is obviously going to be, where is the actual enemy player? Because they are somewhere here on this map. I would assume if we have semi-symmetry that they're like down here or down there, but we're gonna find out. They could be somewhere in the middle. I'm not sure whether any of these maps are specifically generated with just two players in mind, or whether it basically takes a 3 or 4 player map and then just puts you on it. Either way, let's just quickly take a look at how this game works. Every person starts with their capital city. This capital city generates 3 resources: gold, building materials, and divine favor. All of these are obviously used to upgrade your locations and to upgrade what is going on in your army. If you right click on the city, we can actually take a look at what is going on inside. You can see we have our hero. If I right click her, then we can see that this is Alinka the Cunning. She is a starborn, a monster, and a knight. She has a ton of stats, which we don't need to worry about. The way this works is that currently we can only have 2 units inside of our army, and I can recruit these 2 right here. So this city enables me to get an archer and of course a very, very noble melee unit. With this unit, so with this hero, my experience, I've played a bit with it already, is that you want archers, because this unit is very mobile. You can do a lot of microing, which is not that common in this game otherwise, and with that, well, it obviously is very, very beneficial if other people are just standing back, not getting damaged. We're pulling the aggro and they just shoot. As you take your unit, you will notice that you have certain movement points. We have 10 right now, and if I move right here, that will use 2. There are no squares, there are no hexagons, this is just an open world map, and you can move as you please. And now that we're looking at this, right, they got some melee units, they have... I'm not a fan of this catapult, I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm still gonna attack in the hope that I can juke them. And this will also bring us to a point where I can then immediately show you how combat works in this game. As you take a look at this, you will see that this is an auto battler. You can see that my units have immediately started walking, they have started making their way to the enemy. This guy is already shooting us, which is not great, but hey, it is what it is. We can't take personal control of these units. That is not how this system works. You basically prepare your armies, you investigate what the armies of your enemies look like, and then you try to set yourself up in a way that you can destroy them as easily as possible. However, there are battle cards. Every hero has certain battle cards, and you sometimes get other adjacent cards there as well that you can utilize. In this case, we have two battle cards and the retreat card, which I would prefer not using. We have the Wings of Wrak. The Hochmeister flies up and smashes into the target area, hitting all enemies in range with a power 5 attack. So basically, this guy is very mobile, and I can very precisely determine where I want her on the battlefield. Right here, for example, we can land maybe like right between them, hopefully hitting both of them. But honestly, I'm gonna focus on this Star Shower Catapult because, well, if I'm close to it, if I'm fighting it, it should stop shooting my archers and that would be perfect. Let's just hop in here and let's hope that that is the right move. Now that we unpause, we can see that we hop on it, we do a good chunk of damage, we can zoom in here as well. This guy's currently charging, which is why he's like kind of going off to the side. And this is basically how this proceeds. I'm gonna go ahead and do another jump here, and you can see we take off, we land, we do damage to the people right in front of us right there. And the entire idea of this game basically is that you build an army and then you micro certain elements of it via these battle cards that refresh after you use them. In short, that means that I think this fight is one, they weren't really well prepared, they didn't have much going, and as you can see, my jump is highly effective against these particular units that we have here. I have experienced the opposite as well. This hero is a really, really specific hero. We're gonna recruit more heroes as we play here, but yeah, some fights are not easy with them. We didn't quite level up. That is, you know, a level up would be great for us right here, but either way, I'll take it. After every fight, you take over this location here, for example, and you get some loot. Now, this loot is not immediately added right here to your gold. Instead, if we take a look at this location, it goes into our loot wagon. And the loot wagon itself currently holds 52. Per loot wagon, you can have 100 gold. If you lose a battle, for example, the other side gets all the loot that you were carrying. And if you go into one of your main cities, what it basically needs to read right here is, you can see it on the left side there, supply. You go into one of your main cities and then you can stash that loot and actually utilize it. Currently, we can't do that because, well, after fighting, you have zero movement points, which means this was the end of our turn. This is the quintessential aspect of this game. You build your armies, you go around, you fight, and hopefully you can defeat the AI. Alright, and we have not taken over this watchtower. I think it takes one round after you take it to just, you know, become a normal building rather than being a building in unrest is what they call it. But this watchtower currently has no use to us because it is destroyed. What we're going to do is use this card. This is a rebuild card. Basically, depending on the location, depending on what is going on there, you may be able to do different things. For example, this city isn't destroyed, so I can build it up. If we zoom out, we can see this is prosperity level 1 of a city. If this fills, it can then become prosperity level 2 if I invest in it. In this case, I'm just gonna say, all right, build this one up, make sure that it actually stands tall, and all of a sudden, it reveals a ton of stuff to us, and oh Jesus Christ, okay. So this is dangerous. When I see a skull, I cry, okay? It's a very dangerous thing. This over here is a proper walled city, which means we would have to siege it. That is going to take a couple of turns. Can't even tell, though, for how long we would have to siege it. Either way, what we have right there, okay. God, this is a difficult start. We have this mountain range right here in our way, then this hellscape territory down there. I think we first want to, like, make a right here in the east. Okay, anyway though, what we're going to do truly first is we're going to hop into our city because, well, we have some gold, we can hand that over. You can see it now was indeed handed over, and every turn we can recruit more units. And what I would like to do is, so what we have here now, since we only can have two units in our active army, is we also have two reserve units. So if we're out in the field, we can't recruit anything new, but this unit dies, I can just put one of these in instead. That is what we're currently prepping, essentially. Alright, let's attack this army right there. Oh, this seems like a passage. Very interesting, if it is a passage, because that would mean that I can ignore the stuff down there. Anyway, my point here being, we're gonna try to take them over entirely because I hope to level up and draw a really good card as my next ability, but we'll see. I hope that this is also going to be a pretty easy fight, but I don't like either of these. I think they can both charge, and charging enemies will be the death of our archers. Let's just hope that we can get away with this. Obviously, we're gonna land on them. That did great damage. Oh, I love that. And you know what? I'm gonna pull out my second card, we haven't used it so far, just is a jump essentially, so I can pull myself out of any action so that I don't get wounded and can just, boom, there you go, hop in again. That was very, very efficient. This fight is effectively over right now and they didn't get any chance to harm our archers or really, oh god, to do too much damage to our main unit here, but it's worse than I would have hoped, okay? We took almost half of our health as damage here. Either way, we did win yet again. We got some loot and we finally leveled up. Thank God. With this level up, we can now actually play this level up card and hopefully pick a new good card. What do we have here? Coordinated attack. All friendly ranged units shoot at a random enemy in the target area, ignoring normal range restrictions. Oh, enemy's defense is reduced by defense boost for duration seconds. So I'm not sure for how long, but I like that. Seems to be, you know, somewhat buggy. Hey, it's a demo. Don't worry about it. All enemy combatants within range are sucked towards the center of the target area and stunned for 5 seconds. And this is just an upgrade to the ability we already have. No, I am going to go so hard on having ranged support units. I think this is the way to go with this hero right here. Alright, and now that we are indeed looking at turn number 3, I think we are going to go on. Just explore the east right here. I don't like that at all. If they don't say anything, it's a roughly equal fight. They can also say this is suicide, in which case you probably don't want to be attacking there. Okay, I think I want to take this fight and then push down there. We do have now another hero that we can recruit and that we will recruit. Oh, I can't quite make it. I really hope that I'm reading this right, that we don't want to attack this tower. This seems to be very dangerous. If we click on this as well, you can see that there is a mega unit. I love this. I love this art. Seriously, this is like a king knight as his evil ghost form, right? Very, very cool stuff. The silent emperor right there. Now that we have moved our hero down here, now that this fight will happen once the AI moves, and then I can take this with this hero, I would also actually like it if we could hire a second hero. Now this hero is one of my favorites because it makes you so much money. This is a different unit type. It's called a rogue, right? This is Valen the traitor, and he has the ability Pillage 3. Immensely increases gold rewards from battles, pillaged locations, and explored adventure locations. Absolutely gorgeous. What that means is, the more battles we do with him, the richer will we be, the better, of course, will we be able to upgrade. With him, what do we have here? We have just a couple of infantry. Okay. Honestly, that's... I'm not sure whether you're worth anything. I do like this. We got the classic cavalry right there. I'm going to deposit you up there together with him, and then down here, we will just have the melee units. So that basically they storm in, and then the melee units come in immediately after. Ooh, you know what? I'm going to move down here. We're just going to explore this, okay? We got to take a look at it. We have this fresh army going on. It is everything that he can command. He has a command limit of 4 out of 4, so he can command more units than the other hero that we already had here. And now comes the time... I'm gonna lay siege to you? Oh god, this may be a mistake, okay? How many turns is it until we can attack? 4 turns. Okay, and I'm noticing now. Ooh, I hate this. So they're close by, and they could ambush us here. If you're besieging something, the enemy can ambush you. I think I'm going to attack them first. Oh, I can't move further. Oh no. I am a good gamer. I'm a god gamer even, okay? Let's just press end turn and hope that they don't attack us. Oh, well, you know... So that ain't great. Our units are basically looking the other way, and they can come closer and closer and closer, and eventually we will find out, hey, there's people behind us and things are kind of difficult, but yeah, we are definitely at a disadvantage here. Now this hero has a different ability, you can see it. We spawn gold. The people that are not in melee combat, that are enemies, are attracted to it, and after a while that gold will explode. You know, meaning at least some damage, hopefully some good damage. We're doing some great damage against them here, I guess. Our melee units are actually great against these, what even are they? They are armadillos, right. Cowardly kobold mounts, not very adept at fighting, but very useful when building up locations. I think we're gonna win this, but I'm not sure that after this battle we can actually still take the city itself. Because, you know, our units will be wounded, we won't be in an ideal spot. We'll see. Anyway, let's win this battle as it is, and then let's move on afterwards. Look at them go. Yeah, we're gonna win this, but I think I have to withdraw from the city. At least we're getting some experience out of this. But laying siege without knowing whether there are enemies around, definitely not my smartest move. Oh well. It is what it is. You win some, you lose some. In this case, we're doing both at the same time. Oh, that's a lot of XP though, and that is enough for him to level up. You know what? I'll take it. That is a huge get. Because it does mean, you know, some of my units get deleted, but he now gets a new ability. Right, what can we get for you? Encamp army isn't awful. You know, it is what it is. Sabotage. Now that is, it's a great card. Listen, that is a great card. I've used this. Basically, you walk up to a walled city, you play sabotage, you can attack instantly. It is so, so good. But I don't have the money to throw around for this, so currently I think I'm just going to upgrade Fool's Gold. I don't really see any other way. I need more combat ability if we are going to pull out. And now that he has this combat ability, I think I'm going to keep sieging. I'm going to play it really, really hard here. Really, you know, dangerously, in the hope that we can win this thanks to his better abilities. He is, of course, it has to be said, if we take a look at his units, right? Yeah, they are wounded. This guy has one person left over. We do now have our new ability here, coordinated attack. All friendly range units shoot at a random enemy in the target zone. I'm going to, I think, put you down like right here, and then I'm going to immediately make you jump in right there. So we're doing big, big damage to this guy and big, big damage to that guy. Hopefully also, by the way, making it so. Look at that, beautiful. That the, yeah, okay, the dogs are indeed staying here. My big worry would be if the dogs went to our archers, then our archers can't shoot, our archers are gonna die. I'm keeping them busy. That is basically the name of the game right here. All right, and all is well that ends well. We have succeeded, we make a good chunk of money, and we have taken the location. This location actually will do things for us. You can see this right here, once the unrest ends. So next turn, we will get 5 gold and 3 building material. We could also pillage this location. I don't think you want to do this at the start of the game. I could be wrong, but I don't think you want to do this at the start of the game. If you pillage a location, they're gone and you have to rebuild them, which costs you resources. So yeah, I don't think this is something that you want to start off with. I'm just going to abandon the siege. I don't think we're going to do it. I don't think that is going to be viable for us. Let's just go into the main city, and you know, before we do anything, let me just check. So the watchtower also, oh no, actually, the watchtower does let us recruit units. Oh, that is interesting as hell. Okay, let me just go back in here. I'm going to recruit units here. More importantly, though, I'm going to deliver my gold. You can see we're now up to 200 again. We could get a new hero, but you know what? Let's not bother with that. I would much rather just fill up my units, and we're going to stay in the city for the time being, just so that these two can actually be refreshed, right? And then with our units down here, we have one roaming army that could reclaim this building next turn, but I think I'm going to reclaim this. Getting 2 bonuses out of these settlements, I think, is bigger. Now I'm looking at this. Oh yeah, they're both level 2. All right, okay. Let's take this level 2 settlement. It would be a huge boon for our building resource generation. All right, let's hope that this guy can survive, but I have my doubts just looking at it. I have my doubts here, okay? I am nicely pulling these guys away indeed from the archers. That is the big goal. We need to make sure that the archers do not die. They are basically the bulk of our army here, the bulk of what makes us so strong. Let's deal with these guys hopefully immediately. It's a pretty good attack, not a bad attack at all. Oh no, I think my hero is gonna fall. Actually, she seems pretty resilient to the attacks of these guys. I have 1 health. My hero's dead. Okay, archers, it's all on you now. And it's not looking good. It is not looking good at all here. Oh my god. Our archers stand no chance against the melee unit here. That really sucked. That really sucked. This is quite the precarious position that we're in here. Let's recruit more units up here. We can only get 1, that's completely fine. Don't worry about it too much. We need to bring him back into action. We could try to take this tower now, but honestly, I don't love that. I don't love that prospect just yet. We could try to go back for the city, but I think I'm just going to swing around. You know what? Let's bring all of the might of our troops into the southeast here. Let's see whether I can't win down there. Please. I really need that dub, okay? All right. Well, second time is the charm. We should now be able to clear this out very easily because they have 3 units. This is something that is consistent. If you weaken a location, it will be weakened. I seem to have a bug right here, but I'm going to restart the game in just a second to see whether that gold heap will go away. But yeah, okay. This was obviously now a win because I lost it the turn earlier. Get absolutely eviscerated. I got 6 loot out of this. Are you kidding? You gave me 6 loot? All right, anyway. We have 1. We could pillage it. I'm not going to do that. I would much rather actually claim that afterwards. I think I might just... Here's what we do, okay? I'm going to go ahead and hand these over to our dear friend. And then our dear friend is going to go back to our main city, making it so that we can deliver that gold. That sounds pretty good to me. Look at that, literally just like a small gold caravan. All right, perfectly fine. This isn't fine, but I can't do anything about it. So let's just pray that this watchtower can, you know, stand on its own. I'm going to summon a new unit here just... There is going to be a siege here anyway, and then we got a couple of units in defense, so... Let's hope that they can't make anything happen here, but they're 4 units. Maybe they can. All right, gold delivered, and that was most certainly worth it. I'm actually going to go ahead and do something that I didn't think I would be doing. I'm going to recruit a new hero right here. And then I'm actually going to kind of like prop up this particular hero. I think it's not a bad choice at all. Let's push you into the army reserves right here, right? We're going to have big, big reserves. And then this hero is the one actually collecting them. This is the Hierophant, which is a healing unit, which is a unit that is really, really, really strong if you use it right. And I hope to do just that. This hero can heal here, needs a couple of turns anyway. But the Hierophant will be immediately viably walking around. And I mean, that is the dream, right? We have a ton of units now. We have a fresh Hierophant. I'm going to move into this direction. I reload the game, by the way. The gold heap is gone. So if you're experiencing that, that is how to get rid of this. Now, this army with the Hierophant is pretty good. The Hierophant is a crazy, crazy unique unit. Oh, and he's the only one right now inside of our heroes that actually uses the Divine Aura or the Divine Favor power. And that now means that I can summon a celestial unit. Okay, I'm a big, big fan of our potential right here. This unit basically summons, it has ranged attacks, lightning, it can throw comets, and so on and so forth. There's a lot going on here. You know what? No, I'm taking that back, actually. I'm gonna take you with me. I'm going to lay siege to that city, and this time I will have a reserve to freshen myself up. But for starters, let's just take a look at how the Hierophant fights. Because like I said, he fights quite differently from the other units. Ooh, I don't like that charge though. That is a nasty, nasty charge. What we can now do is throw a literal meteor. You know what? Let's just do that. Boom, there you go. Everybody else is dead. Our units look still quite healthy and we can keep moving on. You can see our two units right here are summoning lightning all around. The Hierophant is a really, really cool, interesting unit. In this case, he might be our big siege winner going forward, right? Definitely very impressive right there. Oh, and we immediately get a level up. That is actually huge. Let's take a look at this. We could make it so that our units will die within the next 10 seconds, or if they die within the next 10 seconds, they explode and do damage. I could say affected friendly combatants become immune to damage and negative morale for 6 seconds. Oh, wow. Or we could upgrade the building that this fella here can build. But you know what? I don't think I'm gonna do this. I'm going to go ahead and use protection. I want to keep my units alive as much as possible. Laura, Holy Brother, let's get that done. Now, obviously, this was our turn. We can't do anything else, but I can take this fella down here and maybe claim this location right there. I feel like I at least want to try, right? We got to come back to this eventually. I don't think this is something we can do right now. Yeah, okay, you know what? I don't see the enemy yet. Let's push in right here. I don't see any hostile armies. Interestingly enough, this one was just empty and I just took it over and oh my god, look at who I found. Eisenburg. This is the capital city of our enemy. So we spawned up here, they spawned down there. I don't know where their army is. I don't think I can take that city yet, in particular because their army is roaming around somewhere, but we have found them. And we have a pretty good blocker of locations they have to take first before they get to us. Now, luckily, since I just took this over and, well, nobody was in it, I can just move on and immediately conquer something else as well. And I shall do that because this will, of course, further isolate our enemy city. They must have, like, swung around the southwest, right? Other than that, they would have been where we are now and had already taken those. Oh, they already damaged. The enemy already tried defeating these people here. They must have failed like I failed earlier. All right, I'll take it. That's an easy, easy victory right here and an easy location to give us more resources. I love the spear units against these big guys. They are so goddamn good. They do so much damage. Just gorgeous. Absolutely beautiful. No, you know what I actually think happened here? I think they held this location and then a random, you know, basically like this, the wilderness army, the world army, took it and that's why they were damaged because they fought the garrison just now. Oh, interesting. I think this is winnable very, very quickly because of how exposed the enemy is. I expect their army to, like, turn back and fight us right here. And if we defeat them, I'm going to start sieging. All right. And now I'm going to say, instead of actually attacking the city right now, I'm going to go for this location right here. With the Hierophant, I'm pretty, pretty comfortable with actually attacking and winning, right? We should be able to do this. Let's go ahead. Let's do it. It has a skull atop, so... let's hope that we can take this down. Now, let's remember, we got protection. Obviously, I'm going to use this right away. These units will be immune to this charging damage, which is Utras. Oh my god. I love the Hierophant and I love this unit. It's so beautiful. And now the comet comes in and just completely eviscerates our enemies. I like the Hierophant. That might be my favorite hero. That is insane just how they melt away here. Absolutely gorgeous. If we build the Hierophant Tower, we will also be looking at a situation where we can summon more of these special units, which, yeah, should be beautiful as well. Actually insane. The Hierophant is the literal hero of the story right here. All right, and now that we've taken it over, let's rebuild this right away, actually. Wait a minute, if I rebuild you, right, what can you do for me? If I rebuild you, can you summon, like, creatures for me here as well? Oh my god, bringing this full army is insane! I'm going to put one here into garrison and then just, you know, move another one in. We also have a couple of loot wagons. That's completely fine, don't worry about it too much. Now the big question is, do we rebuild this? I don't think we do. I don't think we do. So hear me out here, right? I do want to build one of the upgrades. This guy gives us the Golden Temple, which then of course generates divine favor of us, which is huge because of the Hierophant being amazing. But I really want to reinforce this location right here. Next turn, I will be able to build a Concorda Haven, which gives this location plus 5 gold, plus 3 building material, and lookout, fortified, and regeneration, which effectively means I can abandon this location and they will have to besiege it to take it, which, yeah, sounds amazing to me, right? So I think that is basically what we're going to engage in here. I do want to scout a little down here just to see. Ooh, is that... do they have a separate other city? There's no way. Yeah, look at that. They conquered the western stuff in. I think I swooped in as the AI took this location. Let's sit on this and let's rebuild it next turn. I'm going to put pressure on an enemy. They just came looking and were like, nah, I'm not. I see ya. I'm not dealing with that. Okay, the AI is very aware that I'm around and they're not happy about it. Anyway, we can now actually move on and... boom, there you go. This makes it so that this location now has a wall, it needs to be sieged, it is in a much, much better spot. And for me, all it means is that I can now move on, leave this city alone, and reclaim some other locations. What we're gonna do, for example, is I'm gonna go right here, and then try to take... it's empty. They didn't leave any garrison. They did not expect us at all. I've completely overwhelmed the enemy. I love that, I'm sorry, that is beautiful. It also does mean that there is a hero of the enemy somewhere over here, so let's just stay cautious. But, oh, and that is what is going on here. They already conquered their first proper reinforced settlement, whereas I'm still struggling with it. Good to know. All that basically means is that, yep, that is a danger. I have to besiege that, and I think I'm gonna besiege that first. I think my battle plan here is to bait them into attacking this. This unit will turn around, defeat them, and then we're gonna try to take that city. Now, with our Hierophant... oh, with a Hierophant, I could lay siege over here. But you know what? No. Let's secure our first city here as well by just laying siege to this one. I swear to God, if there's going to be an ambush by the AI, I'm going to lose it again. Okay? And they're attacking us here. And I can't do anything. I don't have any abilities to utilize here. That's okay. They're going to take this location and we're going to come back from it. Yeah, look at their hero. They have the same guy. I see. They have the guy that summons gold just as we do. They took the tower. When it does not seem like it is as easy as I thought. They already took this tower back. They have at least two other heroes down there with proper armies. Now, I could sit on this and just try to keep them occupied, and it might be the best option, but... I mean, my god, if I took that location, would it not be beautiful? I reckon it would be gorgeous. I'm gonna commit to the siege. I want both of these cities because that would give us massive, massive benefits compared to where they are. Alright, let's lay siege. It's gonna be 4 turns. Yeah, that is... we are now preoccupied with sieging, which means this is the only hero that I can actually actively move around, so let's do just that. Let's put some units into this army and let's get going. I need to put pressure on them down south so that these sieges can proceed properly. And then after that, I actually need to turn around and take that. But let's not get hung up in the details here. We're gonna march down here. And we're going to just make sure that they can't push too far. If they lay siege to this, it's going to take them one turn at the very least, so I can definitely reach this. If they go up here, that's not good. That would be bad. Yes. Yeah, and they took this back immediately. I really should have just pillaged it, honestly. I should have just pillaged it. That is definitely a lesson for the future. And quite frankly, they are also over there. They might just kill us there also. My thinking here is, I'm going to pull out this garrison. Just so that I have something in the reserve. And then I'm going to move... see, I think I'm just going to pillage this location right here. Why wouldn't I, right? I think I'm just going to make their locations completely useless, right? We're going to go down here. We're going to say, hey, how's it going? By the way, I have pillaged your stuff. And you have to rebuild it if you want it again. which should be good, I think. Gives us 100 gold. I mean, listen, I'll take it. That's not bad at all. And then for the time being up here, let's keep sieging. I think we're going to get an ambush here. Shouldn't be too big a problem. The Hierophant is amazingly well equipped. So that means we now have these two locations. This is a destroyed location. This is destroyed. And this is reinforced. This is huge. This one right here is definitely a big boon for us that I was able to just reinforce this. Meaning they can't take it all too soon. And I have armies nearby. Meaning I would ambush them if they do siege it. That's the plan. Oh, and we are being attacked. And that is a pretty big army. Oh, that is a huge army. Okay. All right. I may die. Maybe since we are just now refreshed, I can actually defeat them here. It's looking okay. We took out the hero. All of my units. Actually, there are a couple of archers right here. Most of my units are dead. I think we got this. At great loss, but I think we got this. Oh, they're fleeing. They actually retreated after they saw that I had cleared them out. That is a ton of XP. Thank you so much for leveling me up. I appreciate that. All right. So we defended this rotten location that nobody cared about, but I'm very happy about this because this is a huge boost now to our hero here. Ooh, and we got a tiny ambush. Basically, I think they basically are reading this as we need to protect this town, which is fair enough, but I don't think this army is going to cut it. I think we're going to completely trash you here. I don't see how we couldn't. Yeah, look at that. I even baited them into just, you know, basically going to the gold pile right here. Didn't sadly get pulled in enough, but yeah, we have amazing units right here. I think we are very well equipped. I think we're going to win the siege, and I think we're going to come out ahead. Dude, huge XP gains right here. Thank you so much. Eviscerated. That's all I can say. Now, these heroes, by the way, when they die, they don't die forever. They will respawn after, I think, like two or three turns. But we have now killed two of their heroes. One up there, one down there, which means there's at best one left or two left right here. I think we can deal with it. I think we can handle that. This investment, seriously, right here, was amazing. I really can't wait, by the way, until this actually gets multiplayer. I love the idea of playing 4X games in multiplayer, and I have never finished one in my life. We've played so many, be it play by email, be it, you know, in actual sessions. I've never finished a single 4X campaign. This right here reminds me a lot more of like, what is it, Heroes of Wesnoth, right? We've done several sessions of that. We finished that. I think this one is one of those things where you can actually finish games with your friends. What the hell? Where are you coming from? How many heroes did this guy hire? I feel like, at this point, I feel like I should have hired way more heroes. All right, well, not an issue. We have gates breached right here. Siege ends in one turn. I'm going to retreat into this location together with you. Let's, you know, stick around. Let's keep it safe. I could build you up as well. But you know what? Let's not do any of that for the time being. I need a new hero. Which one do we get? Another hero fan. Thank God. I love you. You are so good at video games. Another hero fan seriously is huge. And it does mean I can start moving into this direction. I don't know that we're going to reach the other hero here, but I'm going to try whatever I can, right? Oh, I wish I could. I wish I could hit him with it. Oh, but what I can do is actually build a golden temple. And I'm going to do that right here. This is a reinforced location, meaning they can't take it in one go. And this reinforced temple is now going to give me a lot more divine favor, which is huge since we now have two hero fans. Can I attack you? Ah, oh, so close. Oh, we are so close. All right, next turn we're gonna get you. For now, let's take over this city. Now, honestly, this is not that serious of a fight. I don't think we can really lose this. Well, I would be surprised anyway, because they just have box standard units. I have amazing units with protection, with lightning damage everywhere, with meteors raining down on them. Come on, what even is a competition here? Okay, I said all that, and then I'm very close to losing. I think I will win, though. And I have a ton of units in reserve, so I'm not too worried, but that's a lot of units dead. A lot of units died for this. Okay, all right, I'll take it. Our second city, finally, in our control. Jesus Christ. All right, if that is any indication for this fight right there, it's gonna be bad. It's gonna be bloody as hell. All right, let me take a look at you, right? We have a ton here just hanging around. I think we'll be okay. It's really great that we had all that reserve. I think that is going to be huge for us going forward here. Now, last hero, can't really move, can't really do much there entirely because, of course, we need him down there. I could try to curse somebody here, but I'm not going to bother. I'm just going to keep this hero right where they are. I'm going to put you into the garrison and then we're just gonna relax. Now this right here is a really strong ability. Well, both of these, I would love to take both, but I can only take one. Sabotage makes it so that you can instantly attack. In, you know, normal cases you would have to siege, and here you can do it right away. But this one, a stampede, calls up to two of your golden artifact wagons to charge on the target position. They get a power buff of one and trample. Basically meaning I can add more and more and more units as combat goes on, which is huge if we want to win this battle. Now let me examine this though. I do have somebody, oh thank god that I had somebody right here. We have three gold wagons, which means I can call all of those in. Man, these units are not doing too hot, but we have to now attack. There's no two ways about it. What does the city look like? It's empty. I win. You lose. I'm a god. You are not. All right. And with that, we have three proper walled cities. Very, very nice. Incredibly powerful. And you can see right here that they also do something for us. When we enter a properly walled city, we can deposit our gold wagons, which means, yep, we're going to see huge influx of gold going forward here. And I'm actually going to go ahead and, okay. I'm going to use this immediately to put some people onto, you know, the back ranks here. Okay, wow. I think I'm just going to move in here as well. Listen, when it comes to map control, I feel really good about this. They just stormed this with one hero. I can just take it immediately after. We have great map control of all the big, big cities. And let me just look around. They control these locations down there. They're getting good payouts from this since it's level 3. That much is for sure. I didn't bother upgrading my stuff. But we just hold more locations and more meaningful locations. I mean, look at that. 25-10. And this one will also do the same in the next turn. Okay, next step, I will kill you. Should be pretty easy. It's a hero fan. It's a gimme. Look at that guy, he's basically cooked. I mean, come on, don't even. He ran into that and just died. He just decided to perish. That was his lot in life. And then I hit them with a meteor. I love the hero fan. It's just so fun to watch. All right, and now here's something that we haven't actually explored much because I didn't really take much of these locations. Edelbert's Tower right here is a specific, you know, kind of location, a very special one because it will allow us to recruit different types of units. This one is, for example, an Acolyte of Rites. Play to recruit a unit of Acolytes of Rites, elite priests summoning Celestials to aid in battle. And now here we are in the last couple of moves of this playthrough, I think. We have taken basically the entire map. I've upgraded a ton. We are making, oh, so much income here. Now, we just need to take the city, and that might be difficult because, wow. There's a lot lingering there, so we may actually need several attacks. We're going to see how it goes, but you know what? Let's start by actually using this guy's ability, making it so that the power of cursed units is decreased by one. If the target is a location under siege, reduce the remaining siege by one turn. I'm going to pick up this guy right here. Let me actually verify this, right? Yes, we have all of the army units present that we can have present. You're going to lay siege to this. Oh, are they trying to defeat us coming out here? Oh my god, okay. I guess they're trying to break the siege, which, fair enough, makes a lot of sense. and I think they're gonna actually succeed here. Luckily, we have, of course, more armies in the back. But wow, okay. They normally aren't that aggressive, but I guess this is their last city, so that makes a lot of sense. I'm actually willing to lose most of my units as long as it wears theirs down, because I have more in the background, like I said. So, basically, go ham. I might even let this hero die. I just need you to be eviscerated as much as is viable. And you know what? Now that I'm looking at this, maybe we can even win this. I mean, honestly, a couple of good meteors and this would be over. Oh my god. I love meteors. They actually fled. Let's go. That is what I am talking about. Ah, absolutely beautiful. Oh my god, the city is empty. The city is empty! It's over. You're cooked. It's over. And I think I can even reuse this guy's ability. Oh my god, I can. Look at that. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna speed the siege up even more. And now next turn, we win. That's so cool. Gates breached, baby. It's over for you. You got nothing to say, you got nothing to do. You're cooked. Easiest win of my life. Look at that victory. God, I love the interface of this. This is honestly Visually speaking, this is an incredible, incredible game. After a long and arduous campaign, Alinka reigns victorious. Now a new chapter begins in the history of the Thousand Kingdoms. And that is us checking out Songs of Silence right here. Like I said, there is a ton of replayability even in this demo. Make sure to check out their Kickstarter. And if you dare, you can even play with all of these AIs. This is going to be a game, I think, that you should have on your radar. So make sure to check it out. I will see you later, alligator.